But first up is Soline Jean-Bac of France. She was a champion in the downhill earlier.
We'll see if she can translate that powerful, strong skiing, Karen, into a little bit more dynamic, a little bit more aggressive skiing that's going to be needed to bring home the gold in the Super G today. Ooh, some nice air. Tips got up a little bit. She is leading at the split. She's so strong and so powerful.
And just 17 years old, as we mentioned earlier, won her first world championship as a 15-year-old.
She started young and she's going to go a long time. I can see her in four more years.
And she will be well ahead of the pace when she crosses the line. You see her time, 1:14.13. Jean-Bac setting the pace in first place.
She likes to be in that leader's position.
And here is Wollstonecroft of Victoria, BC. She won the Super G in 2002, finished fourth here earlier in the downhill, a disappointing fourth. Looking for a better result today.
Well, she's a lot more aggressive than Soline was. She's got her hands up, she's in the tuck, she's in her bullet, she's looking for speed. She does have to work with the fact, Karen, that she is a little bit of a lighter athlete than Soline, and Soline's going to carry a little bit more speed through the flats.
Well, like a true crazy Canuck, she said she prefers the speed events, Wollstonecroft does, over the technical events.
You can see her gritting her teeth and making these turns happen. She wants to be on the podium, which is so important in speed. Ooh, a little bit late there, but that's okay. Super G is one of those events where you can make up the speed and make up the momentum by being loose and dynamic. You're okay.
Well, she looks a little bit behind the time of Jean-Bac, 2 seconds back, 1:16.13. Lauren Wollstonecroft will win the silver medal in the Super G. Wins gold. On to the women's sitting division in the Super G. This is Lori Stevens of the USA, one of the big stars in this division.
She is one of the big stars, not only in the division, but in all of disabled skiing, Karen. She's got the skill, she's got the talent, and she's really got the determination. You see her pushing, looking for speed coming out of the start there, quickly getting into her what we call a sit-ski tuck, and the angulation that this girl can build up through the turns, getting the hip low, getting the shoulders square, but really letting the ski track around. You see that, Karen? That is really tough to do. She's just gaining speed on every turn here, just gaining, winding it up like an elastic band. Nice and calm through the flats. Ooh, this girl's a smart skier, Karen. Wait for her to come over to roll. A little bit late, but like I said earlier, the Super G, you know, you gotta be dynamic and kind of roll with the punches, Karen.
Set up for those turns a little bit early, as she does there, to cut the angle, get the straightest line down the hill. Lori Stevens laying down a great run, a fearless run so far.
She is making a few mistakes, but it is Super G, and you know what? There's no points for style. This isn't freestyle skiing. This isn't snowboarding. This is ski racing, and all that matters is that clock at the end of the race. Really nice turn there, really hooking it around, smooth arc, tip-to-tail skiing. Ooh, she's even in her tuck with the right outrigger up, trying to break the wind. This is the type of run, Karen, that's going to make a lot of the guys at the bottom nervous, to be honest. Just gaining speed. The shock is working well. The sit-ski's working well. And she's got the confidence, which really helps in these Super Gs. Two-handed tuck.
And at the finish line, no doubt about it, Lori Stevens with the time to beat, 1:19.16. That is going to be hard to touch.
If there is one athlete, it is this athlete, though, Karen.
Well, she's a newcomer to the Paralympics, Kimberly Joynes of Edmonton. She suffered a snowboarding accident, and hence she is a sit skier now. This is her first Paralympics, and as you said, Stacy, she either wins, gets on the podium, or is in the fence.
She's so aggressive, and she comes from a snowboard background where sometimes fourth and fifth place. Ooh, really nice air. She's so comfortable in the air, and that comes from that snowboarding background. She's linking some turns together here that are really nice. A little bit looser style than we saw earlier with Lori. But that's Kimberly. Very patient there. I liked how she was patient. She could be getting the outriggers up a little bit to help break the wind, but she's learning. You know, this is her first Paralympic Games.
Well, taking it all in and really seeming to roll with the punches, she did not finish in the downhill. She ended up in the fence. Well, but so far, so good here in the Super G.
She's got the attitude that's needed. She's just got to be able to focus a little bit. Like that turn you see there, really nice turn. Got the arms and the shoulders really square. It's so important for the sit skiers to have everything going down the hill, Karen. You don't want to be sitting across the hill, and you don't want to get the upper body rotated. And she's doing a wonderful job keeping everything square.
As a coach, what would you do with an athlete that's always going for it the way she is?
I would just try to get her to go like that all the time in training. The more she practices going 100% full out in training, the more comfortable she's going to be going full out in the race, which is going to equal a more comfortable athlete, a happier athlete, an athlete that's on the podium a little bit more often.
Well, almost laying it over on his side there, just carving beautiful turns. Here's Kimberly Joyness heading towards the final pitch down to the finish line.
She's having herself a pretty decent run here. I think she might be able to pop in for a podium. Let's see how it goes.
Nicely done. Kimberly Joyness comes in for a bronze medal, 123.04 her time.
I'd always like to go a little faster, but
now to the men's visually impaired Super G. This is Gerd Gradwall of Germany.
He is a big threat to Chris Williamson and guide Bobby Taylor. This is kind of turning out to be a two-man horse race here, if you will, Karen. Some really nice skiing here by the Germans. Ooh, got in the back seat, and it's going to cost them a little bit with the overall speed and the overall time. Again, you can hear just how firm this piste is, Karen. It is a rock out there. These athletes really got to set a good edge and look ahead to make it happen.
Well, they kept the injection that they had for the women's races at the Olympics, and the sun has also been beating down on this course after very cold nights, so firming it up quite a bit.
I can see the sledge hockey boys having a good time out here. It is so icy. And we see some really good skiing here through the red-blue combination by the Germans. Gradwall wants to make it happen. He's trying to make it happen.
And at the finish line, he is in first place for the time being. His time, 111.90. Up next, the man who won silver in the downhill, Chris Williamson of Canada, his guide Bobby Taylor. They've been a great combo so far in these games.
And I can only see this combo getting better in the years too, Karen. More importantly, better in the week. We saw a bit of a slow start for the boys. They wanted the gold in the downhill, but coming out now like gangbusters, really being dynamic, staying loose, which I mentioned before, is so important for Super G. 74.9 kilometers. These guys are hauling the mail.
In his other professional life, Williams is an accountant in Markham, Ontario. It's a fairly new pairing. He skied with a different guide in Salt Lake City, Stacy.
He did, Karen, but you know, the true champion and the true world-class athlete that Chris is, he can adapt.
And you see they are behind the time set by the Germans, 114.53. Williamson in fourth place, but because of a protest, he moves up to third.
The number one position.
Still with Super G action. This is the men's sitting division, and this is Vancouver's Scott Patterson, 44 years old, competing in his second Paralympic Games.
Scott's looking for a good week this week, Karen. He's got a brand new sit ski. He's working on a lot of technique with the sit ski, and we're going to see how it plays out here today in the Super G.
Finished 20th in the downhill earlier in the games. He won bronze in the giant slalom in 2002.
He's got a lot of nice weight going forward. He's got a lot of weight on the front of the ski, which really helps initiate the turn, Karen. Ooh, and he goes down. The ski comes off. That does happen sometimes with the sit skiers. Very unfortunate for Scott. He was looking fairly good up top. Something to do with the binding, Karen. He's got to get that binding turned up or find some way to keep that ski secure. That just shouldn't be happening.
So Scott Patterson of Vancouver does not finish in the men's Super G. Let's take a look at how the other Canadians